The quick lube business is very competitive. That means customers have many choices of where to take their business. As a service writer, greeter, or technician, your job is critical to your location's success. Customers come to you because they want fast, friendly service, because they have confidence in the products you carry, the standards of service you set, and your ability to consistently meet those standards day in and day out. This video is designed to help you be the best you can be at your job and how to ensure a satisfying experience for your customers. The customer greeter is perhaps one of the most important of all jobs. You are the front line, the first person a customer meets. As a greeter, you set the tone for a customer's entire experience. In fact, the customer greeting is often the weakest link in the customer service chain, creating a negative impression before you've even begun your service. That's why the greeter must be friendly and motivated, with good communication skills and a neat, clean appearance. Like a good Boy Scout, the greeter is always prepared. You may want to have the following items on hand and nearby: clipboard, working pen, good supply of customer write-up sheets, floor mat seat covers, greeter scripts, price sheet, any promotional offers. As soon as a car shows up, it's everyone's responsibility to announce the customer's arrival. This way, you'll be able to acknowledge the customer within 10 seconds, even if it's just a smile and a wave during busy times. The quickest way to disappoint customers is to make them feel like nobody notices them or cares about their business.
Hello, welcome to Quick Lube. My name is Zach. How can I help you?
I'd like an oil change, please.
Okay, we have your Quaker State.
When you meet each customer, bend down to eye level so they can see you comfortably. Greet them with a smile and a welcome. Once you recognize the vehicle they are driving and their mileage, you can recommend the right Quaker State motor oil for their car. In most cases, if you point out the benefits of full service, they will follow your recommendation. If the customer prefers bottled oil, be sure to mention that there may be an additional charge for this service. This is also the time to mention any additional services your lube center may be featuring, such as water blades or ATF service, for example. Then ask for the customer's name and address and print them in the right places on the service order. If you are unsure about a customer's name, ask the customer to spell it for you. Then spell the name back, double check your work. If your lube center utilizes the POS system that identifies customers by name via the car's license plate, you may be able to greet the customer by name as they enter your lube center. For safety reasons, it is recommended that the customer not drive the vehicle into the bay. So thank the customer by name, open the car door, and then direct the customer to the waiting area. Providing fast, friendly service is a total team effort, and every member of the team should work together for the benefit of your customers. Remember that every moment you spend with a customer is an opportunity to show you care about their needs and value their patronage. If your customer's happy, your boss will be happy, which means you'll be happy. Quaker State. You know the name. Now get to know one of America's most recognized brands better. One of the true powers of the motor oil industry, Quaker State has helped lead and define the market for decades. It is a name that consumers have trusted for over 100 years, one that represents a history of quality, high technology, and outstanding protection. From NASCAR's Victory Lane to Main Street USA, Quaker State has become synonymous with customer satisfaction. We were the first major oil supplier to introduce a line of products in clear bottles. First to create specific oils for different types of vehicles, and we were the first to offer a DIFM warranty program. For these reasons and many more, you can trust the quality found in every Quaker State bottle. Not all motor oils are created equal. To understand how best to choose the motor oil that's right for you, you first have to understand the differences between conventional, full synthetics, and synthetic blends. Conventional or mineral oil is a mineral oil that originates underground and is pumped out as crude. It is then refined to improve its performance properties, and additives such as detergents and viscosity improvers are blended in. Higher mileage engine oils are specifically formulated for vehicles with over 75,000 miles. They contain specific additives for older engines that condition seals and help prevent leaks. Synthetic oil is a man-made lubricant. Originally created for jet engines, synthetic oils have such a wide range of performance, they can protect engines at temperatures cold enough to turn conventional oils to jelly. Synthetics tend to resist high temperature evaporation, thickening, and deposit formation. And like Quaker State Advanced Engine, full synthetics provide truly superior performance compared to conventional oils. Synthetic blends are a combination of mineral and synthetic oils that offer better flow properties than conventional oils. Blended oil is becoming increasingly popular for vehicles that undergo severe service, such as high-performance cars, vehicles that haul trailers or carry heavy loads, or SUVs that spend part of their lives off-road. Quaker State synthetic blends include Quaker State 4x4 and SUV and Quaker State High Horsepower. Now that you know the big differences between types of oil, you'll better understand the unique qualities of each Quaker State product and how to recommend the best oil for your customer. Whether they pull up in a luxury sedan, a hard-working SUV, or an older classic, you'll have oil at your disposal that was designed exactly for their vehicle type and driving style. Here's a quick and simple explanation of our product line. Quaker State Peak Performance is a conventional mineral-based oil. It is formulated to reduce friction cars in their prime. Quaker State Higher Mileage Engine is specifically formulated for cars with over 75,000 miles. It contains additives for older engines that help reduce friction, condition seals, and help with leaks. Quaker State 4x4 and SUV Synthetic Blend is specially formulated to reduce friction and protect against engine stress under heavy loads. Quaker State High Horsepower Synthetic Blend is formulated to reduce friction under high heat and high RPMs in cars with over 200 horsepower. Quaker State Advanced Engine Full Synthetic is the best motor oil Quaker State offers. Its synthetic base has high and low temperature properties, which offer superior heat and temperature stability. It is specially formulated for technologically advanced engines, like those found in super high performance and luxury cars that require superior performance. Now that you know some of the basic facts about motor oil, it's important to understand the most common myths, just in case a customer asks. Myth number one, oils from paraffin-based crude are loaded with wax and create engine sludge. Fact, there are two basic types of base oils, naphthenic and paraffinic. Most conventional oils today are made from paraffinic base oil, recognized for its ability to resist thinning and thickening with temperature, as well as its lubricating properties and resistance to oxidation. In the refining process, the crude oil is broken down into many different products. One of the products is wax, and others are gasoline, kerosene, lubricating oils, asphalt, etc. Virtually every oil marketer uses paraffinic base stocks in blending its engine oil products. Many believe the term paraffinic to be synonymous with wax. Some have the misconception that paraffinic oils will coat the engine with a waxy film that can result in engine deposits. This is not true. The confusion exists because paraffin molecules can form wax crystals at low temperatures. In lubricating oils, this wax is removed in a refining process called dewaxing. In order to ensure that we produce the highest quality base stocks available, Quaker State removes the maximum amount of wax possible during the refining process. Myth number two, if the oil turns dark or black quickly, it's no good. A common misconception is that high quality motor oil should come out of the engine looking clean at the time of an oil change. Nothing could be further from the truth. Fact, if the oil is doing its job of keeping the engine clean, it should be dirty when drained. Quaker State motor oil may start looking dirty a short time after it is put to use. In the case of diesel engines, the oil will be dirty within a few hours of operation. These are signs that motor oil is doing its job of keeping soot, dirt, and other combustion contaminants in suspension to be carried to the filter or removed from the crankcase when the oil is changed. Myth number three, using synthetic motor oil will void a manufacturer's warranty. As long as the synthetic product meets the viscosity and performance requirements outlined in the vehicle's owner's manual, using synthetic oil will not interfere with the warranty coverage. However, one exception would be the rotary or Wankel engine used in certain Mazda vehicles, which recommends against the use of synthetic oil in that particular engine. Myth number four, you can't switch from synthetic oil to conventional oil or vice versa. As long as the synthetic motor oil product and conventional motor oil product meet the viscosity and performance requirements outlined in the vehicle's owner's manual, you may interchange them with each other. Number five, synthetic motor oils affect engine seals and result in excessive oil leakage, or synthetic oil can't be used on high mileage engines. Synthetic oils do not cause engine oil leaks. Deteriorated and hardened seals and gasket material cause engine oil leaks. The seals are already leaking with conventional motor oil, they will leak with synthetic oil. Synthetic oils flow better at both hot and cold temperatures. So if a seal is leaking, synthetics will exaggerate the leak. If the seals are in good condition, synthetic oils may be used in high mileage engines. Myth number six, engines have to be broken in before using synthetic oil. It was common years ago for engine manufacturers to recommend non-detergent oils for engine break-in. This is when the pistons used cast iron fairings, and the rings needed to wear some to seat into the engine. With today's technology of oils and engine manufacturing, engine manufacturers no longer recommend the use of non-detergent oils for the break-in period. In fact, many engines today are factory-filled with high-quality synthetic or synthetic blend motor oils, which contain high levels of detergents and dispersant additives. Myth number seven, synthetic oil lasts longer than conventional oil or extends the oil drain interval. Quaker State does not recommend extending oil drain intervals beyond the severe service maintenance interval of 3 months or 3,000 miles, whichever comes first. Also, we are unaware of any automobile manufacturer in the United States that currently recognizes using any synthetic oil beyond the recommended oil change intervals outlined in their owner's manual. We emphasize severe service since the majority of motor vehicles are operated in severe driving conditions, such as short trips under 10 miles, dusty or sandy conditions, cold weather, extended idling periods, short towing, or other harsh conditions. Under ideal conditions, however, such as a dust-free climate, highway driving, light loads, perfect engine performance, etc., the oil drain interval may be extended to the vehicle manufacturer's recommended normal service period, generally between 3,000 to 7,500 miles. Contamination by normal wear, particles, water, fuel, and other combustion byproducts, as well as additive depletion, are the main reasons for changing conventional oils on a regular basis. Synthetic oils are equally susceptible to this problem. The only way to remove these contaminants is to change the oil and oil filter within manufacturer's recommended intervals. While it is desirable to change the oil filter because of dirt and contaminant buildup, it is nearly impossible to detect when that condition exists or is about to occur. Regardless of how good an oil filter appears to be, it only makes good sense to change the oil filter at every oil change. Myth number eight, heavier is better, thicker is better, or you can tell the viscosity of oil by feel. There are two main reasons why vehicle manufacturers recommend thinner or lighter viscosity grades of motor oil. First, a gain in fuel economy can be achieved with lower viscosity oil. At cold temperatures and at startup, lower viscosity oil flows better and will reduce internal engine friction. About 10% of the engine's horsepower is lost to internal engine friction, resulting in a drop in fuel economy. Additionally, vehicle manufacturers are struggling to meet corporate average fuel economy, or CAFE, requirements set by the government and avoid paying associated fines. Any fuel mileage improvement associated with a lubricant use would be good for them, and lighter viscosity grade motor oil helps achieve better mileage. Second, thinner motor oil is essential for easy starting, particularly in cold weather, and for proper lubrication once the engine starts. Today's smaller engines have smaller clearances and tighter tolerances between moving parts, and there have been some instances where camshaft damage has occurred because of inadequate lubrication with higher viscosity grades in colder weather. Thinner oil, such as SAE 5W30 or 5W20, will flow faster than heavier motor oils during startup and initial engine operation and will help protect the engine from excessive wear. Multi-grade oil will also offer the same high temperature protection as single-grade motor oil. Always check the vehicle owner's manual to select a proper viscosity grade based on the expected temperature range. The viscosity grades recommended by the vehicle manufacturer depend some on engine design. Engine manufacturers have spent considerable time and expense experimenting with different viscosity grades and have indicated in the owner's manual the grades they feel will best protect the engine at specific temperatures. While one manufacturer's engine may require an SAE 10W30, another manufacturer's engine may require an SAE 5W20 viscosity grade. This is likely due to different tolerances within the engine or other engine design factors. Myth number nine, I don't drive under severe conditions. Even with the best oil, after a while the additives are depleted and the oil becomes too dirty to function effectively. Although improvements in engines and oils and the use of unleaded gasoline have extended normal service oil change intervals to as long as 10,000 miles for some vehicles, the recommended interval for severe service conditions is generally 3 months or 3,000 miles, whichever comes first. Because most drivers operate under severe service conditions, such as stop-and-go city driving or heavy hauling, Quaker State recommends a 3-month, 3,000-mile oil change interval. The time limit may come before the mileage limit. Your vehicle owner's manual specifies the correct oil change intervals for the car under both normal and severe service conditions. The automobile manufacturers set their oil drain intervals based on laboratory engine test results, fleet test results, and used oil analysis results. They also based intervals on the assumption that the consumer will follow recommended preventative maintenance practices and maintain proper oil levels. Engines that operate with oil levels lower than the full level by as little as one quart dramatically increase the severity of the conditions on the remaining oil in the sump. Even though some manufacturers recommend oil changes at more than 5,000 miles for normal service, Quaker State recommends oil and filter changes at 3,000 miles or 3 months, whichever comes first, unless the manufacturer recommends a more frequent change interval. Myth number 10, bulk oil is of lower quality than bottled oil. Consumers may believe that bulk oil is a lower quality because the price is generally less expensive than packaged products. With Quaker State, our bulk motor oil is the exact same high quality as the packaged product. The price difference is generally the result of lower packaging costs. By now you're familiar with different types of oil and how Quaker State has created a full line of products to meet the different needs of different engines. These motor oils were made for what people drive and how they drive in today's world. The idea is to provide customers with the right oil for the right engine. It's technology that not only makes sense, but can also make a difference on your company's bottom line. Customers are seeking specific products to match their vehicle type, like some of our higher ticket specialty oils, which means you can increase your company's profits by simply upselling customers to the appropriate Quaker State motor oil. Offering a synthetic like Quaker State 4x4 and SUV for those driving up in a truck, SUV, or minivan improves your company's profit margin easily and with little extra effort on your part. So what's the best way to help a customer choose the correct oil? Quaker State developed greeter scripts, which help you take a customer through the oil selecting process. Here's an example of what using a greeter script might be like.
Hello and welcome to Quick Lube. My name is Zach. How can I help you?
I'd like an oil change, please.
Okay, we feature Quaker State motor oils, which have been specifically formulated for the type of vehicle you drive. These fine-tuned motor oils have been specifically formulated to help improve...
In addition to a comprehensive line of conventional and synthetic lubricants and filters, Quaker State offers a variety of automotive maintenance and appearance products. This includes Gout engine and fuel system treatment products, Black Magic appearance products, and Rain-X wiper blades and window treatment products. Be sure to make these products available to your customers. Quaker State also offers excellent turnkey promotions and marketing materials that help generate repeat business and loyal customers.
Would you like me to recommend a Quaker State motor oil that's been specifically designed for your vehicle?
Yes, please.
Okay, for your vehicle, we recommend Peak Performance.
We hope this section of the video was helpful in your understanding of the role of the greeter. Likely the most important person in the customer satisfaction chain, the greeter sets the tone for your company's business. The cashier has the last opportunity to create a positive customer impression. Aside from the usual duties, cashiers also have an additional important responsibility to create a positive first impression on potential customers who call on the phone. You'll need to answer the phone promptly, but also be sure to address customers who are waiting in front of you. Telephone customers may ask for directions, for hours of operation, and prices. You can actually win a customer if you're prepared. Always explain the service before quoting the price. This way, the first thing the customer thinks about is the value and is not just comparing prices. Lastly, you or your manager will be responsible for collecting payment from customers when service is complete. Remember, just as the greeter sets the initial tone for the customer, the cashier has the power to leave the customer with a final, positive impression of the experience at your Lube Center. The job of the Quick Lube technician is a crucial one, and it takes skill and training to do it well. If your Lube Center uses upper and lower bay technicians, they are responsible for all services as a team. Upper bay technicians are responsible for upper engine services, as well as exterior and interior vehicle services you may provide, while the lower bay technician performs undercar and lower engine services. As a team, they'll prepare the vehicle for all service and they'll perform all inspections. They'll install new motor oil and filters, as well as to complete the safety check. The customer is depending on you, so it's crucial that you learn proper technical procedures and customer service techniques. It's also important that you practice what you've learned every day with every customer. As a technician, your job begins as you guide the vehicle into the bay. Listen for any unusual sounds coming from the engine and note anything unusual. Your facility then may want to perform a wiper blade or light check. This means that you'll check to see that all turn signals, high beams, low beams, brake lights, and reverse lights are in working order. You may also check the wiper blades to see that they are in good working condition. Always check all fluid levels. Then review the customer write-up from the windshield. If your lube center has upper and lower bays, we recommend the use of the echo system. Simply put, the echo system is a two-way communication system in which technicians repeat one another's commands as they perform the service work. This way, there is no question about what each one is doing. The echo system is proven as both a safety measure and a quality assurance tool.
15-point change, bay 2.
15-point change on bay 2.
Once the car is put into park and the hood is released, open the hood and make sure that it is secure. You may want to start your under-the-hood duties by placing fender guards on both sides of the vehicle to protect it while you work. Over the next few minutes, we will review checking and servicing the engine oil and other fluids and parts. Before you get started, always make sure you have the proper tools and the proper safety equipment, which may include safety goggles or a face shield, gloves, and a thermal sleeve. Prior to servicing the vehicle, make sure you have the proper fluids and filters for the vehicle. First, check the engine oil level. With the engine off, locate and remove the oil dipstick and wipe it off with a clean shop rag. Now replace the dipstick all the way back into the dip tube and remove it again. Hold the dipstick over the rag as you feel the level on the dipstick. Ideally, the oil should be halfway between the add and full marks on the dip. Some dipsticks feature two holes in place add and full, with or with hatch mark in the middle. If the oil is right on the add mark below a hole, it usually indicates that the vehicle is approximately 1 quart low and the driver should be notified of this condition during the consultation. If the oil level is in the safe zone between the two marks, the oil level is fine. When working beneath the vehicle, be sure to use proper safety equipment, which may include gloves, goggles, helmet or bump cap, and a thermal sleeve. Always inspect the oil drain plug before you remove it. Is the drain plug leaking? Has it been rounded off? If so, notify the customer and check your store policy before removing the plug. Place a rolling pan or other container under the drain plug to collect the oil as it is drained from the engine. If you are using the 2-tech system, echo to tech 1 that the oil is draining.
Clear drain bay 2.
Clear to drain on bay 2.
Loosen the plug using the correct size wrench. Using an incorrect wrench can damage the plug. The oil in the pan and the plug are usually hot. Be careful to keep the oil from draining onto you. Inspect the plug again after removal. Make sure the gasket is on the plug and is in good condition. Check the condition of the threads. They should be clean and sharp. It's recommended that metal gaskets be replaced every service. Non-metal gaskets are only replaced if they are damaged. Always install the oil drain plug by hand. Make sure the proper gasket is in place and that the plug is not cross-threaded as it goes into the opening. If you can't get at least 3 rotations by hand, remove the drain plug and try again. Always use the correct size wrench to tighten the plug. A check chart manual contains drain plug torque specifications for all vehicles. Do not over-tighten the plug. You can damage the head of the drain plug, stress the threads, and damage the oil pan by over-tightening. When tight, wipe the drain plug and surrounding areas clean, as well as any other oil that may be dripping from the oil pan or cross members. Remember to always check for possible leaks at the drain plug. Use the latest Quaker State filter application catalog to determine the correct oil filter for the vehicle you are servicing. Again, make sure the correct oil filter is in stock before removing the existing filter. Inspect the new filter and check the gasket to ensure that it is seated in its retaining leather groove. Loosen the existing oil filter with a filter wrench. In most cases, this is done by securing the wrench near the base of the filter to help avoid crushing it and to give you a better removal torque when loosening. After loosening, continue to remove the filter by hand, then drain the excess oil from into the rolling drain pan. Always check that the existing filter gasket is not stuck to the filter mounting plate on the engine. Double gasketing can cause leakage, which could cause serious engine damage. Always lubricate the new filter gasket by using your finger and wiping it with clean Quaker State motor oil. This protects the gasket, removes dirt or dust, and ensures the gasket is seated correctly, creating a proper seal. It will also make the removal of the filter easier during the next oil change. Review the installation instructions printed on the filter. Install the new Quaker State oil filter by hand. Thread it on mounting stud and turn it until the gasket contacts the mounting base. Tighten the filter according to the oil filter manufacturer's instructions. Generally, oil filter should be tightened 3/4 to 1/3 after the gasket contacts the base. Only use a filter wrench if it is necessary to obtain the proper installation torque. Wipe the outside of the oil filter and surrounding area clean of any oil. Once drain plug and filter are installed, if you are working with an upper bay technician, echo that you are ready to add the oil.
Clear to add oil on bay 2.
Before adding motor oil to the engine, check the service order for the consumer's preferred viscosity grade of oil. If the consumer's request is different than the manufacturer's recommendation, attempt to educate and switch the consumer to the manufacturer's preferred viscosity grade. If the customer requests an oil other than the manufacturer's recommended viscosity grade, note on the receipt per customer request. Then check the current lubrication recommendation and capacities guide for the correct viscosity grade and volume of oil for the particular engine. If you have upper and lower bay technicians, echo to the lower bay technician that you are ready to add oil.
Clear to add oil, bay 2.
Remove the oil filter cap. If using metered oil dispensing equipment, place a shop towel around the nozzle and oil fill to avoid possible backsplashing of oil. Also, be careful not to damage the rocker arms inside the valve cover with the tip of the handle. Add the correct volume of oil. Wipe off any excess oil from the dispensing nozzle and replace oil fill cap. Start the engine and check the oil pressure indicator. If no oil pressure develops in the engine within a second, immediately shut off the engine. If you have oil pressure, let the engine run for at least 30 seconds. Inspect the area around the oil filter and drain plug for any sign of leakage. Shut off the engine, recheck the oil level. Adjust the oil level as necessary to bring to the proper level. The level and condition of the brake fluid is critical to the proper functioning of the brake system. Inspect the brake fluid and brake fluid level on every vehicle you service. To check brake fluid, wipe the reservoir cap and open the brake fluid reservoir if necessary. On some vehicles, it may be possible to inspect the brake fluid level without opening the reservoir cap. Verify that the fluid is at the proper level. If the brake fluid is low, notify the customer during the consultation. Low brake fluid may indicate a more serious mechanical problem. Check your store policy concerning topping off of brake fluid. If adding brake fluid to the reservoir, be certain not to let any brake fluid drip or spill onto the vehicle's paint. Brake fluid is not compatible with painted surfaces. Be certain to use the correct DOT-3 or DOT-4 fluid, which can be found in the Quaker State Lubrication Guide. Some vehicles with a manual shift transmission may have a clutch fluid reservoir. To inspect the clutch fluid, open the reservoir, confirm that the fluid is at the proper level. If there are no level markings, verify that the fluid is no more than 1/4 inch from the top of the reservoir. If the fluid is low, check the manufacturer's recommendation and add the proper type of fluid. Most clutch systems use a DOT-3 or a DOT-4 brake fluid. However, always check the owner's manual or a lubrication guide for the manufacturer's recommended product. Or call 1-800-BEST-OIL for technical information from Quaker State. Remember, don't drip any brake fluid onto the vehicle's painted surfaces. Replace the reservoir cap and wipe the area clean, making sure there are no reservoir leaks. Do not operate clutch while the reservoir is open. Vehicles equipped with power steering will need the power steering fluid level inspected. With the engine off and the wheels pointing straight, wipe off the area around the power steering cap. Remove the dipstick, wipe it clean, replace it, and remove it to inspect level. Be careful that no contaminants get into the power steering fluid reservoir while it is open. If the fluid level is lower than the marked safe level for the engine's temperature, refer to the lubrication guide and add the correct amount of fluid. After adding the fluid, replace the dipstick and remove it again to verify that the fluid level is correct. Replace the dipstick and close the cap tightly. The level adjust is completed. Make sure to check for any visible leaks and report them to the customer. Before you begin the oil change service, you check the ATF level. This is a correct procedure to follow. Always check the ATF according to the manufacturer's guidelines. In most cases, the engine should be on with the transmission in park to inspect the ATF level. With the emergency brake on, remove the transmission fluid dipstick and wipe it clean. Then, replace the dipstick and after allowing it a second or two, remove it again. Hold the dipstick over your shop rag as you read the level. Ideally, the fluid should be halfway between the add and full marks. The ATF should typically look reddish in color, and it should contain no debris. If the ATF has a distinct burnt odor, it may need to be changed and may require a professional to inspect the transmission operation. You should inform your customer during your consultation if you detect this. If the fluid is below minimum level, add small amounts at a time and check the level again. Only fill to the full cold. This will prevent overflow when the engine and fluid heat up. Always refill or top off with the ATF approved by the vehicle manufacturer. Do not overfill the transmission. All vehicles require outside air to assist the burning of fuel. The air filter removes dust, dirt, and other particles before they can reach the engine. Because of these contaminants, the air filter needs to be inspected and periodically replaced to maintain proper fuel efficiency and engine performance. First, clean the outside air filter housing. Next, open the housing, which is usually secured with ring nuts or clamps. Make sure that no foreign material drops into the air filter housing or in it. Remove and inspect the air filter. The filter should be replaced if it is excessively dirty or damaged. Hold the filter up to the light to see how much light passes through. An effective filter will allow plenty of it to pass through it. Reference the year, make, and model of the vehicle you are servicing, and identify the appropriate Quaker State air filter in the catalog. Always show the customer their existing filter side by side with a new one, and make sure they want a replacement before replacing a filter, so they are aware of any extra charges. Never attempt to clean the air filter by blowing it with shop air, or tap the filter against a hard surface could damage it. Clean the ends of the housing with a shop rag or vacuum. Place the new air filter in the housing and reassemble it. Make sure the filter is seated properly and the house seals properly. Verify that the wing nuts or clamps are tightened down. Many vehicles today have maintenance-free batteries. However, you'll still need to inspect the battery for any signs of visible problems, such as dirty terminals or loose or corroded mounting brackets. Always be careful not to touch any metal tools to the battery. On maintenance-free batteries, check the charge indicator on the battery. A dark indicator with a green dot means the battery charge and fluid are okay. A dark indicator without a green dot means the battery may need charging. And a light or clear indicator may mean the battery is low on fluid and may need charging or replacing. You should always report the battery condition to your customer during the consultation. If the vehicle has a regular maintenance battery, follow these steps. Remove the battery cap and inspect the water level inside each cell. An indented ring inside indicates the proper water level. If the battery is low, use a battery filler and distilled water to raise the level. Do not use a water hose. Do not overfill. Replace the battery caps and verify that they are tight. Some vehicles contain a positive crankcase ventilation system, or PCV system, which draws gasoline fuels and engine emissions out of the engine crankcase and recirculates them back into the combustion chamber. This helps the engine run cleaner and helps reduce air pollution. These fumes pass through the PCV valve on their way to the engine intake manifold. For the PCV system to operate properly, the PCV valve must be clean. The PCV valve is usually found within a rubber grommet on top of one of the valve covers. To inspect the valve, leave the vehicle engine running. Pull the PCV valve from its housing. You have to detach the hose first and place a finger over the opening. You should feel a vacuum and the engine idle should drop 40 to 80 RPMs. If you feel no suction, the valve may be clogged. The PCV valve should be replaced if it is clogged or stuck, or if the manufacturer's recommended change interval has elapsed since the last change. You can refer to the check chart manual if necessary. Do not attempt to clean and reinstall. To replace the PCV valve, disconnect the valve from its hose using pliers if necessary. Attach the proper replacement PCV valve to the hose and reinsert the valve and hose into the valve cover housing. Refer to the Quaker State Filter Application Guide for the proper replacement part. A vehicle's cooling system is used to regulate engine temperature. When the engine is hot or running, it is extremely dangerous to open the radiator itself because it is under pressure. So coolant level checks and refilling are done through the radiator overflow reservoir. Inspect the fluid level in the overflow bottle. This can usually be done without opening the reservoir cap. If the level is extremely low, notify the customer that a mechanic might need to inspect the system. If you need to add coolant, notify the customer and check the lubrication guide or owner's manual for the correct type of coolant. Remove the cap from the overflow bottle and pour the antifreeze coolant product carefully to avoid spilling. Fill to the proper level using the marks on the coolant reservoir. Use a mixture of 50% antifreeze coolant and 50% water. Replace the cap and make sure it is tight. If the fluid level is always low, inspect the cap to make sure it is in good working order. There are many kinds of gearboxes. The gears inside these systems are lubricated with gear oil that needs to be checked. Transfer cases, differentials, manual transmissions, and transaxles all provide different functions, but they are all inspected and maintained in a similar fashion. Clean the area around the check or fill plug or rubber grommet with a shop towel. Remove the plug or grommet using the correct size wrench. When inspecting gearboxes, make sure you are removing the check or fill plug and not the drain plug. Refer to a check chart manual if you are not sure which is which. Use caution when removing the plug, as overfull gearboxes will often spill. To check the fluid level, insert the short end of a clean Allen wrench through the plug hole and into the gear oil. Be sure that the wrench does not scrape against the inside of the casing and give you an incorrect reading. The proper level is usually even with the plug or just below the opening. After determining the correct fluid, add the fluid in small amounts and check the level frequently to prevent overfilling. Replace the plug and use your check chart manual to confirm the plug torque specifications. Chassis and driveline fittings are connecting points between suspension components and metal parts underneath the vehicle. Although their functions are different, they're serviced in the same way, with lubricating grease. The first step is to inspect each rubber boot and to confirm that they are not brittle or cracking. Notify your customer of any abnormal or damaged boots during the consultation. To service a ball and socket joint, wipe each grease fitting or zerk clean with a shop rag. Press the grease gun straight on the fitting and hold it firmly in place. Slowly add grease to the fitting until the boot just begins to swell or bulge. Be careful not to overfill. Wipe off any excess grease with a shop rag. Follow the same procedure for lubricating grease fitting on U-joints in the drive shaft. Double check that no fittings were missed. Many newer cars have seal joints that do not have grease zerk fittings and require minimal maintenance. The lube center may also want you to check wiper blades, tire, and serpentine belts. Now you're ready to meet the customer. Courteously and enthusiastic approach the customer and politely ask permission to go over the service review. Follow the order of the service review form. Make recommendations about any item that needs to be serviced or replaced, based on the manufacturer's recommended service intervals. Explain how the service will affect the vehicle's operation, how much it will cost, and how long it will take to complete. Listen carefully to customer's response. You can make note on the service order. In the case of an air filter, for example, show the old and the new filters and give the customer a choice. Emphasize the manufacturer's recommendation. No matter what the circumstances, never argue with a customer. Never try to embarrass the customer. Never make recommendations that are not needed, and never act like know-it-all. If the customer decides not to replace or refill any item, politely agree. If a customer chooses to purchase an air filter at a parts store, offer to install it on their next visit. When you have finished, leave a copy of the service review form with the customer and excuse yourself. When all the services have been completed, it's time to perform a thorough safety check. Use the echo system to make sure all service has been performed. Begin by starting the rear of the car, moving to the front, checking all plugs to ensure tightness. In the case of a spin-on filter, make sure the old gasket is intact. Once you've checked all the grease fittings, you're now ready to perform your under-the-hood safety check. Retrace your steps by ensuring that all caps have been replaced tightly and housings are attached securely. Now your manager may want to perform a final safety check. After the final safety check, take another look at the service order and make sure you've entered all the appropriate items. Double-check to see that all of the pertinent information has been noted on the work order, then send it to the cashier for final processing. Your customers are depending on your knowledge and professionalism to properly service each and every vehicle that enters your store. If you have any questions about the procedures you have seen in this program, please feel free to review this videotape again or refer to your Quaker State Technician Training Manual. Safety, quality, and customer satisfaction are the Quaker State standards of excellence. Always focus on these three goals, and you'll have loyal customers that return to your center time and time again.